Thank you very much. Good evening and Assalamu Alaikum. In the name of the Almighty, the Lord of all mankind, you've lived up to your reputation, Steve, because your presentation was excellent. This interface of data, decision making, and digital connectivity, and your accent on transparency. And in fact, you've come to Pakistan at the right time in 2018. Naeem Zimmedar just mentioned some of the points that this is the happening place for information technology and the linking that we are doing with digital connectivity. Naeem mentioned China, and I just like, since I'm chairing the parliamentary committee on the CPEC, the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, I just like to say a few words. And for, before that, I'd like to thank Asfar Hassan Saab and of course Irfan Saab also. I think this linkage or this fusion of Norwegian quality and Pakistani creativity will do a damn good job. And I've noticed that you mentioned this office not as a corporate headquarters, but as a campus, a place for learning, for innovation. And I think that's what it reflects. Pakistan is today at the hub of amazing regional connectivity through the Belt and Road Initiative of China, of which the centerpiece is the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. We have a project which will be ready by the end of this year. It's called the Fiber Optic Cable Project, $44 million worth, and which will have its submarine lending also, and which will have digital TV also, which will connect Pakistan with the region, the 70 countries which are part of this initiative in Asia, Africa, Middle East, and Europe, and parts of Latin America. So we are already there. And you mentioned also about smart meters. I think great minds think alike, because Irfan just told me that they are going to have in Karachi smart meters for K Electric, linkage of Telenor. And one statistic which he gave, which is amazing, Easy Paisa, $12 billion. With millions of people utilizing that. And Pakistan today has a population of 200 million plus, 150 million people having access to telephones, 50 million having access to the internet, 3G and 3.4. And I think it's not just about the digital economy anymore. You know, this is what has changed, and this is what is connecting people. Statistics that we have with the government, by 2020, we could have an outlay of over $1 billion in Pakistan's e-commerce. So I think that, I remember when I was studying in Georgetown University School of Foreign Service in Washington DC, and I went to Hollywood, they say the highest paid person, I asked them, who is the highest paid person in Hollywood? I asked the Warner Brothers studio. They say the highest paid person in Hollywood is the idea man. He gives an idea and the movie is a big success. So you've given us very good ideas. And I think some of the ideas which are there for the politicians also in terms of governance. Because this use of technology, the use of innovation, and the use of data. Because in our systems, and those of you who have worked in government there, where's Dr. Ismail Shah, who did a lot of good work? Dr. Sir, well done. You have as chairman of Pakistan Telecommunication Authority, you have been a pioneer for change and for promoting this digital connectivity. I think it's very important that this transparency which Steve mentioned. In this regard, I think that a role model of this new digital connectivity is what Asfar has done with the Corporate Pakistan Group. Because this is something new, in which corporate leaders, political leaders, media leaders, business leaders, IT people, and on one platform. And there is an exchange of information, sharing of ideas, and I think we all learn from each other. So full marks to you. So the, you qualify as the highest paid person in Hollywood. You came with this idea, and this idea is a success now. So ideas combined with action. Thank you very much, and it's a pleasure to be here. And I wish you all a happy new year. And I wish you a very good stay. Please try our food also, it's finger licking good.